You know, 2008 was a pretty successful season for this 49er women's soccer program. Undefeated in the Atlantic 10, third straight conference crown, NCAA tournament berth, and a win in the NCAA tournament over Tennessee. All of that, and we've lost just one starter from a year ago. That's pretty scary. One thing that is new, though, we have a new signal caller, a new general, if you will. Former 49er men's soccer star has returned to his roots, now coaching the women's team here at Charlotte. And he's bringing a new style of play to the women's soccer team.
We're going to be known for our passing. We're going to be known for a team that shares the ball and hopefully, you know, a team that looks dangerous all over the field.
Keeping the ball on the ground, you know, it's a very English style of play, which is awesome because, you know, as a midfielder being technical, I love that. I don't like the ball flying through the air. I want it on the ground at my feet, and that's what he's trying to instill in the rest of our team, and I'm excited about that.
New coach is a lot different for me. I've never had an English coach. I've never had anybody that's played the way he plays, so it's really interesting. Still learning new things. I'm 20 years old. I'm still, like, learning a lot more about soccer. I don't know, like, I'm kind of nervous about people thinking, like a new coach, but I just want to prove that it's our team who's been winning championships.
He's brought a new aspect to the game. We look different, we're playing different, and there's just things even on and off the field that we've changed, like getting more involved and just little stuff that we didn't pay as much attention to as he's really stressing for us, so it's been good. Oh, gotta love the accent. I've grown up with coaches with accents, and they're the best.
The Niners are going to have an early opportunity to test this new style of soccer when perennial SEC power Georgia comes to Transamerica Field in September.
You know, I know Patrick Baker, the coach of Georgia, has done an awesome job with them, and I actually know a lot of the girls played with them before, played against them this summer, so I was kind of get to see a preview of what I'll be playing against this fall. But I think we're definitely, personnel-wise, I think, you know, we're just as good 11-11 as them, and I think it's going to be a great game, a great matchup.
I mean, they beat us when we went down there, and I mean, that was my freshman year. I mean, I didn't really know a whole lot about, you know, the college game yet, so I'd really like to prove to them just, you know, how far we've come, especially as a team.
I don't look too far ahead. I know Georgia's going to be a powerful game and a team that's going to bring out the best in us. I think that will be an early indication of where we are. It'll also give us an opportunity to test our formation against somebody that's strong, that can put us under pressure, and we want to see how we respond that day and how we kind of combat what they're trying to do. But I think when you're putting new ideas in place, you need games that are really going to test you and give you a little bit of adversity, and I think that Georgia game will be an early indication of how much progress we've made through preseason.
The Atlantic 10 preseason women's soccer poll came out not too long ago, and despite going undefeated last season and losing just one starter from a year ago, the Niners find themselves in the two-hole. That's not sitting too well with some of the players.
Honestly, it's a slap in the face, to be honest, because we've won three titles in a row. We went undefeated last year.
UD is actually where I'm from, and so I have a bunch of friends there, so it's a big rival for me. Seeing that definitely lights a fire, I think, under all of us, and we're ready to work, and ready to get back on top and prove that, you know, we're still the best team here, and ready to show everyone else that, hey, you know, you can pick these preseason teams, but, you know, you didn't pick the right one this time, so we're ready to go.
Polls are kind of silly because, I mean, you never really know. It's everything's up in the air until you start playing.
It's probably extra incentive for the players. I think when they've won three championships, you're looking for new motivation, you're looking for new challenges, and here's another one for us this year.
You know, we won the A-10 title 3 years in a row, but there's someone out there that thinks there's someone better than us. And I think personally, I take that as a challenge, you know, and we're just going to take it and go with it. We don't care. We can't control how other people think, but what we can control is how we play on the field. And we're going to be definitely ready to go come that game.
Fortunately for 49er fans, that Charlotte-Dayton matchup is in Dayton this year, but we are hosting the Atlantic 10 Women's Soccer Championship right here at Transamerica Field, so a potential matchup could linger down the road between the Flyers and the Niners. For Charlotte49ers.com, I'm AJ Mead, and I am leaving because it's hot.